This is the spring and summer clothing trends that are actually wearable. Today's report is not going to be everything that is happening on the runway, but rather how you can incorporate these trends into your everyday wardrobe to update it and keep it modern. So if you like personal style over fashion, then you're going to love it here. My approach to trends is experimenting with styles that are readily available in store to help you find different things that flatter your body and your style and lifestyle the most. In this video, we'll discuss what's trending this year, which pieces to purchase and put more or less money towards, and how to style it in a way that creates cohesive outfits for you to wear in your daily life. I'll start with the trending colors and prints and move through tops, bottoms, shoes, and accessories. This is the Spring and Summer Trends Report. Stay tuned. With colors and prints, we're seeing a lot of bright pops of colors, metallics, white, which is not groundbreaking for spring at all, but there is a difference between all the things that are trending now and I would recommend you buying because they will trend into the future, and what we've seen in years past. So starting out with colors, dopamine dressing is still very much a thing. In my last trends report, I talked about dopamine dressing. This is one that is here to stay. Dopamine dressing just means dressing in a way that makes you feel brighter and happier. Now, as you can tell by the way I'm dressing, I personally like to wear colorful outfits all the time, but I know that a lot of you like to wear neutral outfits. So this is a really easy trend to incorporate because you can simply add in an accessory like shoes, a handbag, or earrings, and bring in that bright pop of color that is trending for spring and summer. Now I want to let you in on the trending colors this year because this is what you're going to see in stores, and I want you to think through which of these colors really works with my style, my lifestyle, and the wardrobe that I already have. What we don't want is for you to bring in this outlandish color that either doesn't complement your skin tone or requires you to buy an all-new outfit that you weren't planning to buy. So instead, think about which of these colors will incorporate well into the clothes that are already in my closet. First off, we have cobalt blue. This is a huge color for spring and summer this year, which is surprising because I tend to think of it more as a fall or winter tone, but that's good because if you buy it for spring summer, you can also incorporate that into your fall and winter wardrobe. The next trending color is lime green, and this was a big one on the runway for the past two runways. We also have lavender, firecracker red, and the 2023 Pantone color of the year. So I personally really love wearing these more rosy colors, pinks, purples, and reds, and I'm hoping that I see a lot more fuchsia in the store to incorporate into my wardrobe. The next trending set of colors are neon accessories. So just like last year, we're still going to see those highlighter pink and yellow and green accessories. You're going to see it in little dainty handbags for the summer and sunglasses. And that's going to be something that if it flatters your style, then lean into that. I've been liking some of the street style outfits we've been seeing with jeans, t-shirts, trousers, and those bright highlighter pops of color. The next color that's trending is white, and if you haven't jumped into this trend for spring and summer yet, I would still recommend that you do so. I think white is always going to be trending, but consider whether you want more of a white, an ivory, an off-white, depending on what works really well with your wardrobe. This year we're seeing a lot more bright white, so that is going to be available in stores, but like I said, it matters more about what works with the clothes you already own than what is trending for the year. The last set of colors I want to turn you on to are bright metallics. Now in years past, metallics have always been a thing, but they've been a darker shade. Now we've got really bright silvers, almost like a white undertone, and gold that is really shiny and bright. Also this year, sequins are back in style. I think during the pandemic, they weren't really that much of a thing because nobody was going to those types of parties. But now we're seeing more of sequin pieces like a skirt or a top, or sequined earrings in just everyday outfits. So that contrast between formal and casual is being blurred quite a bit. Now, as far as prints go, florals are a huge thing as always for spring with a twist, but I want to cover that in the next section about tops. textures this spring and summer are going to be linen, cotton, and any kind of girly kind of detail is going to be back in style. So you're going to see that a lot in stores. You have to ask yourself, does this complement my style? And it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to have very girly style. I've seen a lot of the contrast between the menswear trousers or the baggier t-shirts with little girly ruffled details. And it's such an intriguing contrast when you see it in one of the street style photos. It makes you want to ask that person, what's your story? Some other textures that are in style are fringe, tulle, satin, ruffles, as we talked about, and draped fabrics, which we'll also get into with tops. There are some gorgeous draped tops that we're going to see in stores. I just picked one up and I will link that down below. As far as classic colors, these are things that you don't want to declutter. Things like white, off-white, camel, the neutrals. Those are colors that are going to have a lot of longevity, but this year, another neutral that we're seeing a lot of is black. There are going to be a lot of black linen and cotton and embroidered pieces that are available. I'll put in some B-roll of the black wrap dress that I bought last year and see if that's available to link for you as well. What's great about black is that it definitely works better in the evenings when the sun isn't shining. It can be very versatile for spring, summer, fall, and winter. So consider pulling out some of those black pieces from your cooler weather wardrobe and seeing how you can incorporate that into your warmer weather wardrobe. And as I always say, a personally flattering color palette is always going to be trending because you will always look your best in it. So consider which of these colors really works with your skin tone and the clothes that you already own before you buy into them. Moving on to tops, this year we're seeing a lot of interesting necklines, and I love that because you can decide what looks best on your body or even the vibe that you're trying to give an outfit. Maybe experimenting with a neckline you haven't tried before can create some more interest in your outfits and flatter your body. So with the variety of necklines, we are seeing square necklines, sweetheart necklines, halter tops, and really dramatic collars, especially on blazers. So if any of these necklines are ones you haven't tried yet, just experiment with it. Try it on in store and see how you feel in it. You might find something that you really love. The next trend we're seeing with tops are ladylike details, and this is with both tops and dresses. We're seeing very feminine details, including lace and ruffles and floral prints. But the thing I want to key in on with florals is that we aren't just seeing floral printed patterns, we are seeing a lot of sculptural florals. This is back in style, which is so funny to me because I never thought it would come back in style. Famous last words with trends, right? But the larger floral appliques and sculptural details of flowers is very much trending. You'll see this option with tops, dresses, and with jewelry. So consider whether that really goes with your outfits or if it's something that doesn't really complement your style. Speaking of ladylike details, one of the trends on the runway was the draped fabrics, and I just ordered a draped fabric asymmetrical top that I'm super excited about. I have to pop in a picture here. It's available in a few colors, so I will link it down below if you're interested in that. What I love about that is that it just creates so much interest without adding a pattern. It's a subtle interest. The contrast between the highlights and the shadows with that draping is so beautiful and eye-catching. Moving right along, another trend we're seeing with tops and bottoms really are elevated basics. The thing about basics is that they look so simple, but this year the big trend is that designers are putting a lot of thought and intention into them to make sure that they are truly flattering. So in years past, we've kind of seen that like the boyfriend style t-shirts are in for women to wear, and they're just not really cut for our bodies. Instead, now we're seeing those classics like t-shirts or trousers that are very well thought out. The details are impeccable, and hopefully these pieces provide more longevity than what we've seen with the cheaper basics before. Now, if you want to get into elevated basic pieces, I really recommend cost stores online, which I will put a link down below. But we recently in Italy stayed across the street from a cost store, and although I've shopped online there before, Being there in person was a real dream. The store is so well laid out, and even the online website is laid out very well. We ended up going shopping there, I think, 3 times over the course of a week, and I picked up some things for myself and for my husband because they have great quality pieces that are more simple, elevated basics for men as well. As far as classic pieces for tops, I'm again going to emphasize that if something looks really good on you, then do not declutter it. Can either continue to wear it or give it a rest for just a year. But for tops, the classic pieces are flattering necklines on you, colors that suit your skin tone really well, pieces that get a lot of wear throughout your wardrobe, and the all-time classics are going to be anything in linen, cotton, or knitwork. Something I wanted to mention in case you are looking for more inspiration for your spring and summer outfits is that you can watch runway shows on YouTube. But if you're more interested in how you can apply these trends into your style, then you can look on Pinterest for street style looks. You can even type in jeans, street style, and find different inspiration pictures there that can help you build outfits at home. Speaking of jeans, the biggest trend of 2023 is denim. The difference between denim in years past and denim today is that we're seeing pieces that are much more personally expressive. So instead of just a pair of dark wash jeans or light wash jeans, we're seeing a lot more embellishments, appliques, which were a trend 20 years ago when I was growing up, but they're back trendy again. We're seeing pearl detail, grommets, studs, and undone hemlines, AKA I took my kitchen shears and attacked these jeans right before I walked out the door, which, let's be honest, we have all done. But the most talked about denim look from the runway actually happened in February, so it's more of a fall winter trend, but it's something you can also incorporate for spring. I want you to guess how much this look, modeled by Kate Moss on the Bottega Veneta runway, actually costs. Ready for the answer? $14,000. And that's because both the top and the bottom are actually leather made to look like cotton or denim. Now, if that blows your mind, here's another fun fact. Since I recently came back from Italy, I saw the word Bottega on a number of different stores. So I looked up, what does Bottega Veneta mean? It actually means Venetian shop. So it's like kind of a generic name, unless you are American, and then it sounds very fancy to say Bottega Veneta. Hopefully you've gotten over the sticker shock of that runway look because we're going to draw inspo from it. The baggier style jeans are very in now, and that should actually be a sigh of relief for you, not because you need to throw away all your previous jeans, but because moving forward, you can have more relaxed style jeans that maybe complement your outfits and your body more. I've recently realized that skinny jeans are not that flattering on me. In fact, it can be very overemphasizing for my naturally curvy frame. So if you're someone who has only worn skinny jeans, consider wearing wide leg jeans or flare jeans or even the baggier styles. So you know how I mentioned cost stores for elevated basics? Well, what I found there were same wide leg pink jeans that I absolutely love. And it's funny how just experimenting a little bit with the trends and with different styles can bring out a different part of your personality. I feel like I just have to show up big and bright. And I love that about new styles. Another type of bottoms that are trending again are the denim maxi skirts that you remember from your teenage years. But I'm curious to know if that is something that you would wear again or if it's something you want to leave in the Y2K era. Moving on from denim, another trending bottom that you might want to try are tailored pants. Last year, I actually picked up a pair of linen tailored trousers, and I thought they were such a great find. I know that the same retailer is selling them again this year in several colors, so I will link that down below in the description if it's something that you're interested in trying as well. What's nice about those tailored trousers is that they're not as formal as maybe we once thought. They're not simply office wear. In that contrast between formal and casual, I think it blurs the line between them very well. Another way that you can wear this is with a very feminine top. So you're taking the more menswear style trouser and pairing it with something that is floral or light, ruffly, maybe a halter top. And that also creates some contrast and some interest within that look. Now, as far as classic bottoms, any jeans that you look amazing in, it doesn't matter if the style is trending, if it's personally flattering on you, don't declutter them. If it's something that maybe you're just tired of wearing, save them for next year and see how you feel in them then. But if you want to step outside of your comfort zone and try some new styles, then I recommend some of the wider or baggier styles. Just try it on and see if it flatters your unique body. Before I move on to my favorite category of shoes, I want to share some trends that are trending but I won't personally be buying into. I already talked about sheer tops, but another trend I won't be buying into are cargo pants. This is very trendy, so it's not something that I would spend a lot of money on because even though it might come back in another 20 years, it's probably not going to be in style next year. So if you're buying cargo pants, I would recommend either going to a thrift store or buying something that isn't very expensive. Another trend I won't be buying into is the all white look. Although it is very chic, I'd just be scared that I would spill something on myself or stain it somehow. I do good just to have on a pair of white jeans and not get anything on them. So even though the head to toe white or head to toe off white look is trending this year, I probably personally won't be wearing it. And lastly, a trend that I think is a little bit regrettable is the bubble hem skirt, which you also might remember from your teenage years. If you have a very slender figure, maybe the bubble hem skirt is something that if you step outside your comfort zone, you might actually like. Moving on to shoes, which let's be honest is everybody's favorite. Like I said before, sleek shoes are still outdated. If you'll remember 10 years ago, the tiny little shoes were very on trend. The nude sandals that you couldn't even tell you were wearing, that was in trend. So instead you might see like the platforms, but you're going to see a lot of just the chunkier heeled sandals, which is great because they're easier to walk in. So last year I bought two pairs of block heel sandals, and even though they're 2 or 3 inches tall, they're something that I can wear all day and be comfortable in. So these are the ones that I own and I will link them down below. This year the trend is still strappy style sandals, so you're going to see that a lot in stores, and I personally think it's very flattering and goes with a lot of different outfits, so that might be something you want to try. Another trending shoe for 2023 is the ballet flat. Now, while we will see this in spring, maybe through summer, we're definitely going to see a resurgence in fall and winter. So it might be something you want to go ahead and buy into, a classic pair of leather ballet flats. I don't know if I will, because I just remember my feet being very sweaty from them. But if that's not something that you have a problem with, then ballet flats, I think, can be very chic. But going to the opposite end of the spectrum from a flat, we have the platform pump. This has been trending for over a year and it is still trending. I personally really love platform shoes because they make me tall. I don't think I've ever not loved platform shoes, but platforms are very much in, so you're going to see that a lot in store available for you to buy. And I think it's something that will carry on for the next few years. Lastly, with shoes, I want to talk about a trend that can be somewhat controversial. And I'm gonna call it the cool girl sneakers. I recently bought into this trend and I love it. I think it's such a practical addition to a wardrobe. So we're seeing a lot of the spring and summer looks, the soft florals, the beautiful dresses, the light outfits paired with a chunkier sneaker. And I'm gonna call them the cool girl sneakers because it's always something that is interesting. Whereas before we had those little bitty white tennis shoes that everybody wore, that looks a little bit more outdated now, but I have kept mine in case, you know, I'm traveling and I'm walking 10 miles in a day and I need them, but I'm enjoying more the style of the cool girl sneaker. Now, the cool girl sneakers come in lots of different colorways. Once you choose your style, you still have to make a decision on the color. So what I would recommend if you're buying into this trend is buy something that is a statement piece if you're planning to wear it with neutrals. But if you're planning to wear it with a lot of patterned dresses or shorts and tops, then buy something that is more neutral. Secondly, if you're planning to wear it with athleisure, then make sure that it does coordinate somehow with most of your athletic wear. For me, magenta is one of the main colors I wear with athletic wear, so I bought a pair of sneakers that have a magenta pop to them, along with some other colors. So it still has an interesting colorway, but it goes with my looks. We'll finish off this video with accessories and handbags, but starting with accessories, what I'm seeing a lot of now are the bold statement earrings. It's funny because the last few years, daintier jewelry pieces have been in, but now we're seeing the bold statement earrings that are like one outfit kind of a thing. They don't match everything in your closet, but they're a statement piece. So we're seeing bold jewels, a lot of the large floral appliques as well, or floral style jewels. And so that's been an interesting resurgence. Hopefully you haven't gotten rid of all of your statement earrings from years past, so you still have that available in your closet. But if not, I have found some really cute ones that are affordable that I will link in the description box down below. In the category of jewelry, I still recommend that you have a high quality everyday jewelry set. I have one in gold and one in silver, which gives me versatility with my different outfits. I still recommend you having that high quality set because that's something that's going to last you for years or decades to come. And Missima is one of the brands that I like to buy from. Also Monet if you're into investment quality jewelry, but Missima is going to be a little bit more of your high quality but trendier pieces. And lastly, let's talk about hats. I said this in the last trends report, it still stays for this year. The larger fedoras and the personalized hat bands are still in this year. And I recommend Gigi Pip hats, which I have several. I'm an ambassador for them and I love the quality that they have. They're pieces that can become vintage one day, but for now they're going to really help you define your style. And the personalized hat band to me is such an interesting way to say a lot without saying anything. So if you want to add a little zhuzh to some of your outfits, consider getting a hat for the spring and summer. Interesting to observe the handbag trends over the last few years because we've gone all the way from the suitcase totes all the way to the micro bag. The sizes that are trending right now include extra large totes or shopping bags and also the over shoulder totes that you remember from the Y2K days. Those are back in style. If you're going to buy that because it is something that is practical for your lifestyle, I would recommend not buying the Saffiana leather ones, even though there are designers selling that at a very high price. The Saffiana leather, to me, it really loses the ambiance of leather. It looks like plastic, it feels like plastic. I would recommend staying away from a plasticky kind of leather because it looks more trendy. It's not going to wear well over the years, and instead buying a high quality leather. Now you can spend a ton of money on designer high quality leather handbags, but I have really found that it doesn't matter about the price point as much once you get past a certain threshold. So in the $300 or $400 range, the Polen handbags are amazing. I absolutely love mine. And sculptural handbags are so in style right now. I think it really fits my personal style, so I don't care if it's trending, but it does help that it's trending and so these styles are available for purchase. I've only had this handbag for a little over a year and I have probably worn it 200 times, so the cost per wear is really good on it and it still looks pristine. Another thing you're going to see in store are those extra large shopper totes, which are sort of hobo style. So you have to think, one, does the hobo style match my style? And two, is that extra large size going to overwhelm my frame? So if you're petite, I would definitely stay away from it, but just consider while you look in the mirror trying it on, does this really flatter my body or is it something that is overwhelming me? And as far as classics go with handbags, anything that is really good material in a really good versatile color for spring and summer, like white or taupe or camel and nude, those are going to be your classics that you don't want to declutter. I hope this video has been very helpful for you to find which trends are actually wearable and flatter your body, your style, and your lifestyle. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for more style, travel, and personal growth videos. And the next video that I recommend you watch are the fashion trends to fix outdated outfits. I'll see you next week with a brand new video. Until then, take care.